Hello and welcome to another episode of What's Growing, and I'm here today in what I call Jamun Bagh. The reason I call it Jamun Bagh is because it's made under the grand old jamun tree which we have right there behind us, and the whole garden has been actually set up around this big jamun tree. Now let me tell you a little bit about the background of this area. Basically, when we first started Ananda, we had only 6 acres of land, and we had left this patch, which was at the far south, as the place for us to go grow our crops. So the first year we grew groundnut here, and then after some time we started growing other crops and also sugarcane. But eventually we expanded the farm a little bit and got some more area far away. So we moved this zone to that area and decided to convert this more into a food forest. Hello there, I'm back with my brand new course on water for every landscape. In this course, you will understand what the hydrological cycle is, what your watershed is, and then learn a bunch of earthwork strategies to manage the water on your land. You will also learn how to treat the grey water so that you can treat that as a supplementary source of water. So all the description for this course is given in the description section. What are you waiting for? Click on the relevant links and sign up for the course. I will see you inside the course very soon. Now, what happened at that time was that I was struggling to grow my citrus trees because for some reason they were not doing so well. And I thought it might be because of the lack of sunlight. So if I plant all my citrus trees here down south where I get a lot of sun, then they are going to do very well. So I went ahead and planted a whole lot of citrus trees in this area. But because this area was so far away from me, it fell in zone 4, and it was a place that I hardly ever visited. As a result, very soon there was a lot of undergrowth here and the citrus trees became completely neglected. And they stayed like that for many years. Finally, about 6 months ago, I decided to reclaim this area, build a garden here again, and finally revive all the citrus plants that were here. Of course, I lost some of them, but I still have majority of the citrus trees that I'd planted. And we cut out beds in this area and revived the citrus trees, and have also now planted the understory, which at the moment is urad dal or black gram. Now, urad dal or black gram is a good nitrogen fixer, and it's also a creeper. So as a result, you can see that it's spread all over the floor, providing an excellent cover to the ground and thereby preventing weeds from growing. It also helps to retain the moisture in the ground, and that's really helping the citrus trees because they need a lot of watering. But this place has good drainage because it's on the southern side of our plot and it slopes downwards towards the south. So there is good drainage and there's no waterlogging. Remember, while citrus need good water, they cannot tolerate waterlogging because that often results in a fungal root rot. So that's really how this garden is looking now. And to add some more charm here, I've interspersed it with a lot of flowering shrubs and also planted a whole row of papayas on the edge, such that the papaya circles catch the water running off from the sun garden, which is right to the north of the Jamun Bagh. So when it rains heavily and the sun garden is saturated with water, water tends to run into this garden, but a lot of it gets trapped by the papaya circles and then it seeps through the soil instead of running on top of the soil. So as a result, there is no erosion, and the papaya circles keep releasing water for many days after the rains have stopped because of the gentle slope going down south. So that's really Jamun Bagh, and I'm extremely happy with the way this garden has shaped up, at the attention that the lemon trees and citrus trees are getting again, and the fact that it's become a beautiful spot for us to visit. It's filled with butterflies, small birds, and it's all under the mighty Jamun. And I don't know who said that you can't grow anything under large forest trees. This garden is a testimony to the fact that you can grow anything as long as every plant is getting its share of sunlight. So that's it from me today. I hope you enjoyed taking this little walk with me around Jamun Bagh. And I'll keep sharing more videos of other parts of Ananda with you. So stay tuned, subscribe to our channel, and do share this video with other people who may enjoy feasting their eyes on this rich, lush greenery that you see here. So much from me. Bye-bye.